Good evening, everyone. It's George with the Cross Country Mission. Like that? Hey, just got a little short message for you. So, don't believe the lies of the enemy. Satan come to kill, steal, and destroy. I got a friend the other day I was talking to. Now, he's been working for the Lord. He's been blessed by the Lord. But here recently, he kind of going back to the other side, you know. He slipped. We in the world call it, he backslid a little bit. He backslid. So I was talking to this friend the other day, and I believe that the word of the Lord is good for teaching, rebuking, you know what I'm saying? So I was just telling him that he needs to get back into church, right? That this is the problem, because he's fallen out of the grace of the Lord, because he's now working for the enemy again, doing things we ought not be doing. He's like, oh, well, he told me, he's like, well, you did this and you did that. Yes, I did. Yes, I did indeed. But just like many of you did, we took it to the Lord, right? Lord, forgive us. That's why Jesus died. But anyways, here's the deal. He told me that he couldn't go back to the church. I said, well, why? I said, everybody's going to forgive you. Everybody love you. Jesus forgives you, but he wants you to come back to him. He ain't going to make you come back to him. You want to stay out here living in this type of environment that you're living in? Go ahead and stay. But his thing was, I can't forgive myself. I can't forgive myself. Sure, the church is going to forgive me. Sure, Jesus is going to forgive me. That's a lie of the enemy, I tell you right now. You can't forgive yourself. Well, I'm going to tell you this. If you can't forgive yourself, God can't forgive you. But God loves you. So this parable here, it's about this sheep, the wandering sheep. God wants you to come back. Are you a lost sheep today? Was you once walking with God like my friend was, but now you're backslidden? That's what the world calls it? Listen to this. He says, what do you think? What do you think? If a man owns 100 sheep and one of them wander away, will he not leave the 99 to go get the one? And will he not rejoice over getting that one? A lot more than he will these 99 has never ran off. Because he loves all the sheep. And he wants to get everybody back, okay? He says, and if he finds it, talking about this lost sheep, right? If he finds this lost sheep, he says, truly I tell you, he is happier about that one sheep than about the 99 that did not wander off. So I just want to reassure you today that if you want to make the Lord happy, anything you've done, God don't hold it against you. But he wants you to just to come back to him. Repent, saith the Lord. Turn away from that sin. Has nothing for you. It's just darkness, right? Trying to drag you down in this dark pit, down to that place called hell. We don't want nothing to do with that up in here. We live for the light. We love the Lord. I suggest you just take your problems to the Lord. Throw them on his feet. Beg for forgiveness. How can he forgive a sin that you won't even admit that you've committed? That's all I'm saying. That's all I'm saying. And Jesus also said, you know, the word of God is like a double-edged sword, sharper than any double-edged sword. He said that anyone would be hurting these little kids, you know, it'd be better that they tie a millstone around their neck, throw themselves off into the ocean. You hear what I'm saying? Could you catch what I'm saying with that undertone, hurting these babies? Someone ain't even born, amen? So, woe be to them. Woe be to them. Anyways, I love you. Give your heart to Jesus. Throw your sins right at Jesus' feet. He's going to be so happy to take you back. He's hunting for you right now. He's calling. Can you hear him calling? John, this is Jesus. Betty, this is Jesus. I love you. Say, I love you too, Lord. Can you forgive me? He'll say, yes, I can. Yes, I can. That's why Jesus came, children of God. Citizens of heaven. I love you, Jesus. Love you. Y'all be good. Be blessed.